Let's start with a square, and in it we will inscribe another square. Now we will rotate this smaller square around the bottom left corner of our big square until its upper right corner is touching the upper side of our bigger square, just as shown in the sketch. Now let's say that this smaller square is now divided into two areas with the values of 1 and 3 squared units. Now we will extend the right side of our smaller square until the bottom side of our bigger square, and therefore we have formed this red quadrilateral. Now the question is it possible for us to find this red shaded area? If you want to answer this question for yourself, you can pause the video right now and then come back and check your solution. Alright, so let's solve this one. So first, for the better understanding, let's mark all the vertices of a big square as A, B, C, and D. And let's also mark the vertices of the smaller square as E, F, and G. Now we can also mark the point of intersection between two squares as P, and the point of intersection between the extension line and the bottom side of the big square as Q. Now we can easily get the area of our smaller square AEFG, since we know that its area is equal to the sum of the areas with the values of 1 and 3. So the area of the smaller square is equal to 4. But since we know that area is also equal to the side squared, we can conclude that the side of our smaller square is equal to 2. Alright, so now let's set our attention to the triangle APG. We know that this triangle is actually the right triangle. So we can use the formula for the area of this right triangle, which is equal to the product of its legs over 2. But we know that this triangle has the area with a value of 1. So if we now just substitute the value of the leg GA, we will get the following, and after the simplification, we can conclude that the length of the line GP is equal to 1. So now let's take a look at the line PF. We can see that this line is equal to the difference between the lines GF and GP. We know that the line GF is equal to 2, since it represents the side of our smaller square, so we can substitute the values and get that the line PF has the length of 1 as well. You can now clearly see that the point P is actually located at the middle of the line GF, but of course we did not know this fact at the beginning of our problem. Now let's take a look at the line AP. This line is the hypotenuse of our blue triangle APG, so we can use the Pythagorean theorem, and we can say that this hypotenuse of AP squared is equal to the leg GA squared plus the leg GP squared. We can substitute the values from the sketch, and we can simplify to finally get that AP squared is equal to 5, which means that the length of the side AP is equal to square root of 5. Now let's have a look at the small triangle PFD. This is also the right triangle. You can probably notice that the angles at the point P for the big blue triangle and the small green triangle are the same. This leads us to conclude that the other angles, the angle at the point F of the small triangle and the angle at the point A of the big triangle, are also identical. So we can isolate them for better understanding. We can first isolate the blue triangle, and then we will isolate the green triangle and position it in the same way as a blue triangle. Since those two are similar, we can use the rule of similarity. We can say that the relation between their hypotenuse, FP and AP, is equal to 1 over square root of 5. And this value actually represents the factor of similarity between those two triangles. So we can use this factor to find the other sides of the small green triangle. So, in order to find the side DP of the smaller triangle, we will just multiply the side GP of the big triangle times the factor of similarity of 1 over square root of 5. We will substitute the values and get that the length of the side DP is equal to 1 over square root of 5. We're not going to rationalize this, because it is going to cancel out later anyway. Alright, so let's find the side FD of the small triangle, which is equal to the side AG of the bigger triangle times the factor of similarity. We will substitute our values and get that the line FD of the smaller green triangle is equal to 2 over square root of 5. Now, let's set our attention to the triangle AQE. We can easily see that this triangle is also the right triangle. Now, we will use the fact that we have started our problem with the rotation of the square. This means that all sides of the square are rotated at the same angle. We can use this fact to conclude that the angles at the point A for both of our blue triangles are actually the same. So, this means that the angle at the point P and the angle at the point Q of those two triangles are also the same. Now, since both of those triangles have the same angles and they share the same side with the value of 2, which is actually the side of our smaller square, we can conclude that those two triangles are congruent. This means that both of them have the same area with the value of 1. Alright, so now we will find the area of our smaller green triangle PFD. Its area is equal to the product of its legs over 2, we can substitute our values, and after simplification we will get that the area of this small triangle is equal to 1 over 5 squared units. Now, finally, let's try to find the area of the big square ABCD. We will first find its side DA, which is actually equal to the sum of the sides DP and PA. As you can see, we already got those values, so we're just going to substitute them in, and we will get that the side DA of our square is equal to 6 square root of 5 over 5. Now we can say that the area of this big square is equal to the side dA square, and after substituting the value, we will get that this area is equal to 36 over 5 squared units. Alright, so now let's clear our image a little bit, and let's recap all the areas that we got so far. Now we can find our red shaded area using the area of the big square ABCD, from which we will subtract the area of the triangle AQE, the area of the smaller triangle PFD, and the area of the quadrilateral AEFP. Now, we can substitute the values of our areas, and we will get the following. After simplification, we will get that this red area is equal to 7 minus 4, which means that our red shaded area is equal to 3 squared units, and this is our solution. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Of course, if you know another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section so everyone can see. And of course, until next time, see you all and take care.